back to another fresh video on my channel. This name is Bhavya from the Dapp Gaming. Before we move forward, I'm generally grateful for all the phenomenal calm, love and support you guys have showered for my fun time with making series and ideas. Counting on all the love and support greatly, we have just crossed our first 1,000 subscribers on my channel. Honestly, your support means a great deal of motivation of bringing you the best content since God. One question that always pops in my DM, appreciated in comments and highlighted with my family and my loved ones, that how you edit my pictures. A bunch of inspiration that extremely aids and inspires me, gathering and creating all the highlights in the best possible manner that will extremely helps to boost your content creation with three quick easy ways. In the world of social media, where the first place of attraction getting engaged with your picture, then your content. It's so much important that your picture look appealing to engage the growth of your business. From understanding all the need, I'm going to be sharing my presentation and styling that extremely helps you and boosts your content creation. Last but not the least, one of the most essential that most of the beginners know over is understanding your niche. Niche basically defines a category that you specialize in. It may be the food, fashion, travel and lifestyle content, or maybe the different you wish to choose for your business as a beginner and engaging content. And I just plan for it easy way that extremely turns you much more easier to understand your niche at a beginner level to boost your content creation. With taste, ideology, understanding the specific type of cooking, last but not the least, your audience feedback. I genuinely feel like the ideology is something which is much more important for each and everyone. It's not just about the beginner or the professional content creator. Everyone needs to follow because the audience worth waiting and watching your content only because your creativity, your presentation and styling. Make sure you try always something different. Instead of picking out the content, you first need to select the category you're much more passionate and comfortable with. Maybe the baking, it may be the healthy snacks, or it may be choosing a specific type of cooking, maybe American, Indian or Persian, because their content will extremely going to digitalize and showcase to your audience. It might be a different color grading feed or something that extremely defined to the particular occasion, event or their particular mood that you all you please and connected to. So last but not the least, one of the most essential and one of my favorite that I genuinely need to try to make my content much more connected and fueled. One thing that extremely motivates all the creators' hard work and self-esteem is your audience feedback and response. For the growth of every individual business, there should be a depth of understanding of audience analytics of their likes and their dislikes. And honestly, it turns much more easier for you to classify and planning your upcoming content and style. So now it's time to tune to the one of the most funniest part of the video, where I'm going to tell you my each and every hacks of food photography and styling, covering everything you need, starting from the process, styling, editing and the final outcome. So without further ado, let's get straight into the video. That's your photography. A platform like Instagram is a perfect option in 2020 to grow your business and understand your audience. Platinum photography is quick and easy and one of the most trendiest photography when we talk about the food photography and styling, because you can cover from different angles and showcase your different expressions, moves and reflection of style, palettes and the color tones in it. Basically, the platinum photography, you can cover it from the top of your angle so that you can catch everything from the top. So here are the few quick pictures that I shot this morning enjoying my smoothie mango bowl. Also guys, do let me know in the comment section if you want to enjoy some yummy fresh smoothie bowl idea so that I can plan a special separate video for you all this summer. My two quick tips that extremely want to help you to boost your content as a backup photographer as a business. For one prediction that the most of beginners usually have while capturing their images, that they need proper DSLR camera for their high definition images. But it is not like that. Every image you are watching on my screen is honestly waiting to click through my iPhone, and I'm so much comfortable clicking through it. My second and one of the most important things that the most of beginners not look forward before capturing your images is swiping the camera screen. Many times touching your camera turns our screen much more blurry. It's pretty essential to clean your screen with the cotton and the soft fabric that will turn your outcome much more clear. Confidence is the key. I genuinely believe that the most of people at the beginning usually feel awkward, but with the time you will enjoy the every process. I still remember the time when I first started taking the picture publicly, and it was extremely great part about it because every time you switch to a different place, you enjoy every backdrop with contrasting of your color palette of your different food. So it's always been a great way of styling and increasing the picture. So don't be shy, don't be feel unconfident, enjoy every process, and time you're going to astonish each and everyone out there with your picture. So always believe in yourself, your styling, and you're going to make it worth counting. Composing and styling flat lays are always fun. You can take it forward adding all those things that extremely defines your moods and experience. You can start it forward adding a bunch of accessories that I always use in my flat lay photography for more outcome and detailing are my watches and my few of my silver accessories that extremely makes it much more redefining to the outcome of the picture. You can take it forward adding coffee, desserts, books and your plugins and many more things. The few bunch of apps that I always editing my images are Snapseed, VSU and Facetune. Firstly, I'm going to be importing my picture in Snapseed and adjusting the tune image by making the exposure a little bit more and making the shadow and warmth a little bit darker. Next, I'm going to be making the ambience a little bit more sharper by raising it so that it looks much more highlighting. Next, I'm going to be strapping to cropping my images according to different sizes. You can check this out, but I'm going to be cropping by 4x3, which is the Instagram size. Now I'm going to be exporting my images to the Facetune for the more final edit of the picture. Now it's time to import my picture in the Facetune. I'm going to be selecting the retouch tool and the whiten tool at the next same to whiten up the different parts. You can select different parts according to your need. I'm going to be brightening up the white part of the portion to make it much more look whitened as the same. For my final picture, next I'm going to be stepping to the detail tool to sharpen up my accessories, my watches and many more things you wish to highlight at the same. Now it's time to tune to the last but not the least, VSU. You can also call it ViscoCam. The bunch of apps. After successfully importing my picture in the ViscoCam, now it's time to edit all of them. A bunch of filters that I always love are A6 and A4, but I'm going to be selecting the C6 and C8, but I genuinely love the C6 looks much more great in this picture. So I'm now going to be adjusting all the layers down after a little down and sharpening my image because Instagram usually loses its quality when during the upload. We are all done. I hope that you guys enjoyed. Make sure to give a big thumbs up. I hope that you guys enjoy my video. Make sure you guys give a big thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more such videos coming up next on the way. And don't forget to share in comment section about the flat lay photography and all the knowledge. We love catching all of them, and share your picture with me on my Instagram handle. Until then, much love and luck back to all. Catch you guys in another video with more fun ideas coming up next on the way. Goodbye, much love and luck back to all.